Hi everyone, welcome back. My name is Madison. If you're new to this channel, please just take a moment to like the video and hit subscribe. That way you can stay up to date with all of the yoga and fitness videos that I post here weekly. For today's class, I have planned for you an intermediate vinyasa flow. It is minimal instruction and it is pretty fast paced. So if you're new to yoga, you may want to start off with some of my more beginner friendly classes here on my channel. If not, grab your mat and let's get started. Today we're going to begin sitting back on our heels, tops of our feet on the floor, and just start to sit up tall. Close your eyes, maybe rest your palms onto your knees or your lap. And just take a moment to bring your awareness to your breath. Begin to take a deep breath in through your nose and out through your nose. And then bringing your palms together at your heart center and taking a moment to set an intention for this practice. Maybe a word, a goal, a mantra, whatever your intention is, allow it to sit at the back of your mind between any thoughts that come up throughout the class. And then bringing your hands to your third eye, focusing on your intention, what we think we become. With your next inhale, start to send your arms all the way up towards the ceiling, gazing up at your thumbs. Exhale, bend your elbows, finding cactus arms, opening your chest. On your inhale, reach the arms back up towards the ceiling. Exhale, flip your palms forward and make your way to table. On your inhale, drop your belly, reach your chest forward, look up. Exhale, press the ground away around your back. Inhale, drop the belly. Exhale, round your spine. Inhale. Exhale. And then coming back to neutral, taking your knees a little bit wider as you ease your way back into child's pose. On your inhale, press into your hands, lift your chest, and just start to walk your hands just slightly over to the right and allow your left ear to rest on the floor. On your next inhale, press into your palms, come back to center, and let the forehead come down. On your next inhale, press into your palms, this time walking just slightly to the left and allowing your right ear to rest on the floor. On your next inhale, pressing into your palms and once again walking your hands back to center. On your next inhale, start to look forward and just begin to roll right into full cobra. Inhaling as you reach the crown of your head towards the ceiling. And as you exhale, start to look over your right shoulder. On your inhale, come back to center. Exhale, look over your left. On your inhale, come back to center, and this time on the exhale, let the chin drop towards your chest. On your inhale, come back to center, and on your exhale, tuck your toes, raise your hips all the way back to your first downward dog. And just take a few breaths here to walk it out, alternate bending one knee and the other. Finding your own rhythm, and moving at your own pace. And then on your next inhale, start to come high on your toes, roll your shoulders forward, find high plank. Exhale, press your hips up and back, downward dog. Inhale to plank. Exhale, hips up and back. Inhale. Exhale. One more time, deep inhale. And long exhale. On your next inhale, start to look at that space between your hands, bend your knees, walk, step, or jump there. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive all the way up to standing. Exhale, back to your forward fold. Inhale, look up, plant your hands, and either walk, step, or jump back to plank. Exhale to chaturanga. Inhale to upward dog. Exhale back to downward dog. Taking a deep breath in and a long breath out. On your inhale, look at that space between your hands. Bend the knees, walk, step, or jump. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive up tall mountain. Exhale to forward fold. Inhale, look up. Plant your hands, walk, step, or jump back. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Deep breath in here. Long breath out here. On your inhale, looking at that space between your hands, bend your knees, walk, step, or jump. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive up tall mountain. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, look up, plant your hands, walk, step, or jump back to plank. Exhale to chaturanga. Inhale to upward dog. Exhale back to downward dog. Taking a deep breath in and a long breath out. On your inhale, looking at the space between your hands, bend your knees, walk, step, or jump. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive up tall mountain. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, look up, plant the hands, walk, step, or jump. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale to upward face. Exhale to downward facing. Deep breath in, long breath out. On your inhale, look forward, bend your knees, walk, step, or jump there. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive up, tall mountain. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, look up, plant your hands, walk, step, or jump back. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, back to downward dog. Deep breath in. Long breath out. On your next inhale, start to raise the right leg up. Stack your hip, point the toes to the ceiling. Exhale, squeeze the heel to your glute, opening your hip. On your inhale, leveling off our hips, kicking that right leg back. Exhale, high on your left toes, right knee to nose. Inhale, kick back. And on your exhale, step that right foot through. Drop the left knee to the mat. And on your next inhale, finding your low crescent lunge. Reaching the arms up, and if it feels good here, maybe bringing the palms together, bending your elbows as if you are working your thumbs to that space right between your shoulder blades. On your inhale, reaching back up. Exhale, your hands to the floor. Send your hips back, finding your half splits. Fanning the toes back towards the face, reaching the heart towards the big toe. On your next inhale, bend back into the right knee. Press into your hands. Kick the right leg back, finding three-legged table. Inhale. Exhale, right knee to the right elbow. Inhale, kick it back. Exhale, right knee to the left elbow. Inhale, kick it back. Exhale, the knee to your nose. Inhale, kick back. Exhale, tuck your left toes under and then bring the right knee to your nose. Inhale, kick that right leg back. And on your exhale, set it down to meet your left, finding downward dog, staying here or flowing through an optional vinyasa. On your next inhale, start to raise your left leg up behind you. And once again, stack your hip, point the toes. Exhale, bend your knee, draw the heel into the glutes. On your inhale, kick the left leg back. Exhale, high on your right toes, left knee to nose. Inhale, kick it back. Exhale, step that left foot through. Drop the right knee to the mat. And once again, sweeping the arms up and finding your low crescent lunge. If you'd like more, maybe bringing the palms together, bending your elbows, once again, working the thumbs towards the upper back. On your inhale, reach the arms back up to the ceiling. Exhale, your hands to the mat, half splits pose. On your next inhale, bend back into your left knee, press into your hands, kick the left leg back, three-legged table, inhale. Exhale, left knee to the left elbow. Inhale, kick it back. Exhale, left knee to the right elbow. Inhale, kick it back. Exhale, knee to your nose. On your inhale, kick it back. Exhale, tuck your right toes under, bring the left knee to your nose. Inhale, kick that left leg back, three-legged down dog. Exhale, release your left foot to meet your right. And once again, staying here or flowing through your optional vinyasa. Taking a deep breath in through your nose and out through your nose. On your inhale, look at that space between your hands. Bend your knees, walk, step, or jump there. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, look up, lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold. And on your inhale, start to bend your knees, sweep your arms up, finding chair pose. So lifting up through your chest, gazing at that space right between your hands, neutralizing your back here. Deep breath in. Exhale, your palms to your heart. Here, we'll take a twist, taking our left elbow right outside of our right knee. So still sitting deeply into our chair and maybe looking past that right shoulder. And if you'd like, you can stay here or take an optional side crow, bringing your palms to the floor, keeping that twist, and just starting to shift that weight into your palms as you feel your toes start to lightly come off the ground. One more inhale. And on the exhale, wherever you are, we're going to be back in a forward fold, palms down, hips up. Inhale, look up, lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold forward. On your next inhale, again, bending the knees, sweeping the arms, finding chair pose. Taking a deep breath in here. And on your exhale, once again, bringing the palms together, lowering them down to your chest. And this time we'll take our twist to the left. So as you're sitting low in your chair, focus on stacking your elbows, pressing your palms firmly together, and maybe holding this variation. Or if once again, maybe finding that side crow here on the left side. Taking just one more inhale. And on the exhale, wherever you are, we're going to be back in a forward fold. Hands come down to frame your feet. Inhale, look up, lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold forward. On your inhale, look up, plant your hands, walk, step, or jump back to plank, and take your optional vinyasa. Deep breath in through your nose and out through your nose. And on your next inhale, raise your right leg up behind you. Exhale high on your left toes. Bring the right knee to your nose. Inhale, kick it back. Exhale, knee to nose. One more time. Inhale, kick it back. Exhale, knee to nose. Hold here. And then just start to heel ball toe that right foot between your hands. This time we're going to find a high crescent lunge. So stacking your wrists, shoulders, and hips. Lifting up through the crown of your head. We'll take a deep breath in here. And then on your exhale, start to sweep the arms back, reach the chest forward, engage your triceps. Inhale, reach the arms back up. Exhale, airplane lunge, reach the arms back, reach the heart forward. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And on this exhale, holding here, we're going to find our airplane warrior three, stepping onto the right foot, raising that left leg up, inhaling here. And as you exhale, start to come up, bringing the left knee towards your belly, standing staff. Inhale back to warrior three. Exhale to staff. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, back to warrior three. And on your exhale, step the left foot back. We're going to shorten our stance slightly here. Inhaling as you reach the arms up. And as you exhale, bring the arms behind you. Maybe grab onto opposite elbows or find reverse prayer, bringing your palms together. Inhaling as you lift, exhaling as you hinge from your waist, pyramid pose. And just taking one more inhale. Exhale the left hand to the floor. Inhale that right arm up, finding your revolved triangle here as you stack your shoulders. One more inhale. Exhale the right hand to the floor for half moon. Right hand's gonna be set on the floor right in front of that right foot, right underneath the right shoulder. Focus on stacking your hips and then extending that left arm to the ceiling, stacking the shoulders. One more inhale. Exhale to standing splits. We'll bring our left hand to the floor. So now instead of stacking our hips, we're now going to square them, pointing those left toes. And if you need more, maybe grabbing onto your right leg with your right hand or both hands. One more inhale. Exhale, lunge that left leg all the way back to your lunge. Press into your hands, kick that right leg back, three-legged down dog, and maybe taking your optional three-legged or four-legged vinyasa. We'll meet back with all four on the floor. Inhale, your left leg up behind you. Exhale, knee to your nose. Inhale, kick it back two more times. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale, kick it back. Last one, we're gonna exhale, knee to nose, hold here, and then heel ball toe that foot right between your hands, finding your high lunge. Once again, stacking your shoulders above your hips, and that right heel right above the right ball mound of your right foot. Inhaling. And as you exhale, sweep the arms back, airplane lunge. Inhale, rising back up. Exhale, hinge forward. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, inhale, last one. We're gonna exhale, hold here, finding our airplane warrior three, keeping our arms by our sides and shifting the weight into that left foot. On your inhale, come into standing staff, right knee to the belly. Exhale, take it back to warrior three. Take your time here, inhaling. And exhaling back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more time, inhale. And then exhale, holding that warrior three. We're gonna step that right foot back again. You're gonna shorten your stance here. Inhaling the arms up and overhead. Exhale the arms back. Once again, grabbing onto opposite elbows or reverse prayer. Inhale, lift your chest. Exhale, hinge from your waist. Try to keep the spine nice and long as you reach your heart towards your big toe. Inhaling here. Exhale, revolve triangle. Right hand comes to the floor. Left hand reaches up towards the ceiling. So again, keeping the hips squared here, twisting into the upper body. We'll inhale here. Exhale, the left hand to the floor, right underneath the left shoulder as you work your way into half moon pose. Take your time with your balance. You can keep looking down at that left hand. If you want an extra challenge, try and look up at the right. One more inhale. Exhale to your standing splits. Again, squaring your hips. You can keep your hands on the floor, framing the left foot, or maybe grab onto your left foot with the left hand or with both hands. We'll take one more inhale holding here. Exhale, lunge the right leg back. Press into your hands, kick the left leg back, three-legged down dog, and taking your optional three-legged or four-legged vinyasa. Once again, we'll meet with all four on the floor. On your next inhale, we're gonna make our way towards the back of our mat. So slowly walking your hands all the way back to your feet. And then we're going to take our peace fingers, so our pointer and middle fingers, wrap them right around your big toes. And as you inhale, just look out, lengthen your spine. And on your exhale, bend your elbows, engage your biceps as you draw the belly a little bit closer to your thighs. And just taking one more inhale. And as you exhale, release your grip. Bring your hands down to frame your feet. Inhale, look out, lengthen your spine. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reverse swan dive up. And on your exhale, bring your palms to your heart. And from here, we're going to come into tree pose. So we're going to start by shifting the weight into our left foot. And you can bring your right foot to the ankle, calf, inner thigh. If you'd like today, maybe finding half lotus, letting the outer right edge of your foot rest on the inside of your left hip. And then bringing your palms together, and then maybe sending your arms up towards the ceiling. Taking a nice deep breath in. Exhale, bring your palms together, lower them down to your heart. Try to keep whatever variation of tree you're in and slowly hinge forward as you bring your hands to the mat. And now we're gonna slowly walk our hands forward, try and keep that tree variation. Once your shoulders are right above your wrists, we're gonna drop that right shin to the floor, right into pigeon. On your inhale, press into your fingers, open your chest, and on your exhale, start to melt forward. And we'll be here for a few breaths, just kind of slowing down. So remember to focus on your breath. Remember, the deeper you breathe, the better this is going to feel. Slowly on your next inhale, start to work your way back up onto your palms. We're gonna tuck our left toes under, lift, and then kick back all the way to three-legged down dog. On your inhale, open your hip. Exhale, bend your knee, stay here, or maybe flip your dog over, bringing that right foot to the floor, reaching your hips up as you reach that right arm towards the top of your mat. Slowly flip it back over, bring your knee to your nose, reset your hips, kick it back, and then exhale back to your downward facing dog. Once again, on your next inhale, start to walk your hands all the way back to your feet. We'll start to inhale, look up, lengthen our spine. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, reverse swan dive all the way up tall mountain. Exhale your palms to your heart. And now moving into the other side, we're gonna take the left foot, same variation as the first side, ankle, calf, thigh, or half lotus. And then bring your palms to your hearts. And as you inhale, start to grow your tree, reach the arms towards the ceiling. Taking a nice deep breath in here. Exhale, bring your palms together. Keep your variation as you hinge forward, bringing your palms to the ground. And once again, we're gonna walk our hands to the top of our mat. When your shoulders are right above your wrist, just allow your left shin to drop into pigeon. Inhaling as you open your chest. Exhaling as you melt forward. On your next inhale, we'll start to work our way back up onto our palms, tucking our right toes under. We're gonna lift and kick back, three-legged down dog. Inhale, stack your hips. Exhale, bend your knees, staying here. Once again, maybe flipping your dog. Slowly start to flip it back over, squaring your hips. And on your exhale, let your left foot meet your right. Come back to your downward dog. Deep breath in. Long breath out. And then on your next inhale, coming forward into a high plank, we're going to take our right hand to the center of our mat, stacking our feet, reaching that left arm up high. Take a deep breath in here, opening, stacking. And then on your exhale, we're gonna start to thread that left arm through. So we're coming into a low side plank on the left side. Once again, reaching that right arm up, stacking right foot on left. Inhale here. Exhale the right forearm to the floor, finding low plank. Deep breath in. And then slowly start to raise your hips. We're gonna walk our feet in. And then from here, press into the right palm and then press into the left palm, coming back to where we started, downward dog. And then if you'd like, maybe adding in an optional vinyasa here. On your next inhale, once again, come forward into plank. This time the left hand's gonna come to the center, side plank. We're going to raise that right arm up, stacking our feet, stacking our shoulders. Inhaling here. Exhale, thread the right arm through. Come on down to the right elbow and forearm. Now reaching that left arm up into that low side plank. Inhaling. Exhaling that left forearm to the floor, coming into your low plank. Both elbows on the floor. We're gonna inhale, raise our hips. Once again, we wanna walk our feet in here slightly, a couple footprints. And then from here, press into the left palm and then the right palm, coming into your downward dog. And once again, you can stay here or take one last vinyasa. On your next inhale, we're gonna come into a yogi squat. So walk your feet about halfway up your mat. Bring your feet maybe about as wide as your mat. And then bringing your palms together, sinking your hips low, reaching the crown of your head towards the ceiling. Feeling that nice opening in your hips. And if you'd like, you can stay here for the duration of the pose. Or start to wrap that right arm in front of the right shin, bringing that right palm to the floor. Inhaling as you reach that left arm up towards the ceiling. And then maybe taking a half bind, wrapping that left arm around your back. Or a full bind, wrapping the right arm around the shin as you reach for your fingers. Taking one more deep breath in. And on your exhale, releasing your binds, we'll come back to center, bringing our palms to our heart. And then moving into the left side, once again, left hand to the floor, extending your arms, or maybe taking your half or full bind here. One more inhale. And then on your exhale, release, bringing your palms back together as you come back to center. And here we're gonna take a seat back, coming right into boat pose. So coming all the way down to your glutes, start to extend your legs up as you reach your arms forward and focus on lifting up through your chest, keeping your spine as long as possible. And in here, taking your peace fingers right around your big toes. And if you can, start to extend out through your legs, continue to lift up through your chest and keep the spine long. And then bringing the soles of your feet together, setting them down into the floor into butterfly. Inhale, lift the heart. And on your exhale, start to round forward. On your next inhale, slowly rounding back up. And then from here, we're gonna extend both of our legs straight out on the floor in front of us. Inhaling as you reach the arms up and overhead. And as you exhale, start to melt forward. On your next inhale, start to work your way back up to center. And then bringing the left foot to the inside of your right leg, bending your left knee, we'll inhale the arms overhead. And as you exhale, begin to fold forward. And then coming back to center, we're now going to bend the right knee, bringing the top of the right foot to the floor. And then you can keep the left foot on the inside of the right thigh or find half lotus. Start to inhale, reach the arms up. And on your exhale, twist to your left, bringing your right hand to your left knee, left hand towards the base of your spine. And then slowly release. Come back to center, extending both of your legs. And now keep your left leg extended out in front of you, bend your right knee. Inhale your arms overhead, and on your exhale, begin to fold forward. And slowly start to work your way back up to center. Now this time we're going to bend our left knee back, so top of our left foot on the floor. Right leg can stay where it is, or if you'd like, finding half lotus, resting the right foot on the left hip. Inhale, reach the arms overhead, and on your exhale, this time we're going to take our twist to the right. Taking one more inhale, and on your exhale, release. And once again, we're gonna extend both of our legs forward, coming all the way to the top of our mat. And then start to reach your arms forward, and we're gonna peel down to the floor, one, vertebrae at a time. And once you make it all the way down to the ground, we're going to bring our knees towards our belly and just give yourself a nice big hug here. Maybe rock a few times side to side. And then bringing your arms into a T, start to let your knees and your feet stack to your right as you look over your left shoulder. On your inhale, bring your knees back to center. And on your exhale, allow them to stack to your left as you look over your right. On your next inhale, bring your knees back to center. And once again, giving yourself a nice big hug, pulling yourself into a little ball, bringing your forehead to your knees, and then just slowly letting everything go as you find Shavasana, final resting pose. Begin to relax your lower back. Let go of any tension in your shoulders. Relax your temples. Relax your jaw. And feel the space between your eyebrows soften. Please stay here for as long as you feel that you need today. Thank you so much for allowing me to guide you through your practice. And take a moment to also thank yourself for being here. Namaste.